Okay, before the keyboard warriors get upset, this is not a man-bashing video, because every one of us has likes and dislikes when it comes to what the opposite sex wears, regardless of sexual orientation. We actually posed this question for real, and these were the repeat offenders. Here are 15 things men wear that women hate. Number 1. Speedos. The ultimate offender, Aluxers, was the Speedo. This tiny piece of fabric was designed by a company that has been around for more than 100 years, and they've made sure that athletes around the world had the ultimate in swimwear. But guys, if you're not taking part in the next triathlon, then strutting your stuff in a budgie smuggler is two thumbs down for most women. Number 2. Flip-flops or sandals teamed up with jeans or trousers. Unless you're on holiday in Morocco, this attire is not appropriate for regular everyday wearing. Flip-flops and shorts are not a problem, but this indecisiveness of whether it's not cold enough for trousers and sneakers or not hot enough for shorts and sandals, that makes many women say no thank you. Number 3. T-shirts with holes or stains. Stained and holey tees had their brief moment where they were sort of acceptable. We think even guys went for the trend with a little trepidation, probably remembering their mother's words of how they shouldn't leave the house wearing clothing with holes or stains. Plus, let's be honest, there is a big difference between fashionably stained or holey clothes compared to just plain dirty and old clothes, right? And Aluxers, don't forget you can subscribe to our channel at any time throughout the video. Number 4. White socks with black shoes. We know there was only one person who could pull that off, and knowing what we know now, it's certainly not someone we would encourage emulating. You wouldn't think that something as inconsequential as socks could make or break an outfit, but they actually do. The decision was unanimous. It's a no to white socks with black shoes. Number 5. Man bun. As writer Rachel Arthur wrote for Forbes, if it were up to Google Trends, Santa would have a man bun. And an earlier April Fool's joke published on Forbes advertised, "Clip-on man bun, because why should girls have all the fun?" And while some men can totally pull off a man bun and it looks like it's here to stay, there are just some women who are saying negative. Number 6. Skinny jeans. According to TikTok, skinny jeans have been canceled. GQ magazine reported that TikTok says skinny jeans are canceled. We agree. Author Theo van den Broeke added, "The truth is that skinny jeans really only work when they're worn by improbably skinny people." And Aluxers, after being cooped up at home with little socializing since COVID hit, more people are opting for comfort over fashion. And let's be honest, skinny jeans are not designed for comfort. Number 7. Shiny suits. Look, we completely understand that not everyone can afford an expensive suit, but if you shop with fabric in mind, you can avoid buying a suit that becomes shiny quickly, which doesn't look very good. Cheap suits usually contain polyester. As Gentleman's Gazette confirms, very cheap suits have polyester lining or blends with polyester. GQ gives some tips to how to make a cheap suit look better. They suggest taking in the sleeves, replacing the buttons, adding a cuff at the ankle, and ensuring you have decent shoes. And Aluxers, by decent shoes, we are not referring to our next point. Number 8. Pointy shoes. Besides being damn uncomfortable, pointy shoes just don't look good with, well, anything. And guys, pointy shoes are not a new fashion disaster. A study published in the International Journal of Paleontology confirmed that people in the Middle Ages suffered because of their pointy shoes. Skeletal remains excavated from Cambridge were studied, and it was confirmed that overall, 18% of all the skeletons showed signs of bunions. However, the condition appeared to be significantly more common during the 14th and 15th centuries, the late Middle Ages, than in the 11th to 13th centuries, the High Middle Ages, as reported by Medical News Today. Number 9. Tank tops. If you're at the gym sweating it out or tucking into an ice cream cone on the beach, then tank tops are totally fine. Other than that, most women can't figure out another reason why it would be necessary to wear this flimsy attire. And Aluxers, if you need some more solid advice, here's a great listen on Audible. Off the Cuff, The Essential Style Guide for Men and the Women Who Love Them by Carson Kressley. We've got a free download available for you to aluxfreebook.com. Number 10. Too Tight Tees. This one has a lot to do with age. When you're young and fit, you can get away with wearing tighter-fitting t-shirts, but there is certainly a limited time where this is acceptable. The Art of Manliness says a t-shirt should neither be too baggy or too tight. If it's too big, it'll drape and sag like a pillowcase and be unflattering. Too tight and you'll look like a stuffed sausage. A look that can read as some combination of narcissistic, flamboyant, and/or douchey. Number 11. Sport Team Specific Clothing. It's wonderful that you support the Kaiser Chiefs or you're the number one fan of the Vancouver Canucks, but you don't need to display your unwavering affection to the world. New York Daily News featured an article, If You Must, How to Wear a Sports Team Jersey and Not Look Like an Idiot. The article begins with the truth. Adult men rocking oversized sports jerseys is awful. It screams immaturity and laziness, hinting at loutishness. So there are ways to wear it without looking like an idiot, but is it even worth risking? Perhaps not. Number 12. T-shirts with sayings. Slogan tees are not a favorite of women worldwide. Screaming to the world, I don't get drunk, I get awesome, or game over when someone ties the knot is pretty immature. We don't even recommend those tees for working around your house or garden. Just bin them. Number 13. Camo anything. Hey Luxers, there's a time and place for camo, of course, but wearing it day in, day out is a little bit too much. We fully support function over fashion in this case, but if you're head-to-toe camo and going to the mall, that look isn't going to keep you hidden. In fact, you'll stick out like a sore thumb. And if you need some guidance in the wardrobe department, Aluxers, we suggest you watch our video, 15 Ways to Put Together a Proper Wardrobe. Number 14. Fedoras. There's a lot of hate for the fedora, which, according to Greeley Hatworks, were first seen as a feminine hat with masculine undertones in 1883, inspired by a drama called Fedora, created by the French playwright Victorien Sardou. As suggested by Hoodwinked on Reddit as to why the fedora doesn't have the best reputation, it's only attractive if you're already attractive. It has a certain place and an expiration date. Number 15. Synthetic leather. We get that budget plays a big role in wardrobe, but the drawback with owning synthetic leather is that it may look good initially, but it does not hold that look. Wear and tear sets in quickly, and before you know it, your synthetic leather looks awful, and it's just not a look that works well for anyone. So, Aluxers, what do men or women wear that you find the most unattractive? We'd love to hear from you in the comments, so please join the conversation. Now, you stuck with us until the end, we've held on to a bonus for this very moment. One of the worst things that a man can wear is an ego. Medicine.net claims, men tend to feel worse about themselves when their wives or girlfriends succeed, with their self-esteem sagging rather than basking in the glory of their partner's accomplishments. If you're wearing this kind of ego all day long, it's time to ditch that and focus on wearing joy, gratitude, self-confidence, and kindness. Thanks for watching, Aluxers. We so value your continued support, your likes, and of course, you subscribing.